Where do you imagine? Well, first of all, do you have any? You don't have any personal experience with the wall. You weren't stationed in Berlin.
No, I was stationed in London, at headquarters, 3rd Air Force.
Okay. Where would you? It is going to be exhibited in Los Angeles. My understanding is that the wall will actually span across Wilshire at one point. Where do you imagine it can go beyond that? I mean, you're producing public work to be seen by public eyes. Where does the wall go once it's metaphorically torn down from Wilshire?
Unlike every other project I've ever done, which is always about a specific wall in a specific location, and when I do studies of the entire environment and put that placement exactly at a certain place, I don't know even yet whether I'm going to paint them on two of the panels of the wall. The walls are about 4 feet by 12 feet, actually, the originals, approximately like that. And so at first I was going to do them standing from about ankles up, like I usually paint, next to each other. Then I thought, well, maybe I would take two sections, and put them from head down to maybe here, and really big, next to each other. I'm still not sure how I'm going to do that.
How does the idea that, I guess, if your process usually takes a location into account, then that's actually, that informs what you're going to paint. How is this going to be, how is this different for you? Is this actually, throw a little wrinkle in everything?
Or? It does. I'll have to think modularly in terms of the design. It will have to fit, and I want to paint Terry and Mars' works all around them on both sides, so that most of the wall will be his works that I will supervise the production of and as a monument to Terry. And then the centerpieces would be able to fit within that context or by themselves. Mm-hmm. And Terry's work would be in such a way that they would be able to be put together with the presidents removed, and that would fit as a beautiful monument to Terry's work too, so they could come as two pieces or one. And essentially, I'm going to make them as portraits. And as portraits, they would essentially be able to fit wherever that particular portrait would ever want to be. But certainly, I would imagine outside someplace, this is going to be tough materials. This is the material right here that goes on at first, and then fine plaster, and then, I mean, it's going to be a fine process.
Will you be painting directly onto the plaster, or are you going to be painting?
The same way as with the Michael Jackson. I will paint on this what's called non-woven media, which completely is saturated all the way through. There's nothing left inside. It's just a sheet of pure acrylic that's been, if you will, reinforced by polyester. Oh. And that will go on it with non-woven media, with gel medium. and the wall will simply be as if I had painted it directly on the wall, but I can be in the studio working on the presidents here and on Terry Noir's works too, here in the studio, and then put them up, and they will be, shall we say, 95% finished. And then I'll go out there for those days that they want me out on the wall and finish it up during those days. And so I'll have a chance to make really beautiful pieces.
What about security? You know, like the wall itself is always, the wall itself was torn completely, how am I say it, it was graffitied. You know, that was the first form of resistance, was people coming up, spray painting. It wasn't always art, or, you know, that's always debatable, I suppose. I'm assuming you want your work to be kept free of spray cans, right? Or is there an element of that kind of accident that actually would almost be some sort of poetic reference to the old wall?
I'm open-minded, but not so much that my brains have fallen out. Yeah, I think that probably I wouldn't be open-minded to somebody expressing themselves on anything in a museum or anything that they don't have permission to express themselves mm-hmm. on. I think that's where sort of nihilism comes into it instead of freedom.
So the wall in this case then represents an exhibition point. It's a gallery or it's a museum.
It's no different from anything. It's no different from your car, no different from your porch, your wall, or anything that you own or that anybody owns, anybody's Lexus or BMW that lives in Beverly Hills. Those things, I think the wall should get the same respect that they get, or anything that you own or anybody in LA owns, shouldn't be sprayed without their permission. That's just sort of really easy stuff.
That's,